The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 28, 1974, in Hyderabad, India.
Jnanam Triham Savidhyanam Idam Bhakshami Asesata Yajnatya na iha bhuya anyat jnatabham avasishyate. Yesterday, I was speaking and then meeting at school. So, I began from the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. How to develop Krishna consciousness. This Krishna consciousness movement can be introduced to every living entity. There is a verse in Chaitanya Charitamrita. It is said that Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti. Nitya Siddha. Nitya Siddha means just like we eat. All living entities, they eat. There is nothing new introduction when we eat or sleep or have sex life or when there is danger, we defend. These are Nitya Siddha. Natural. Wherever there is a living entity, these four things are there. It doesn't matter whether he is human being or a small microbe. These things are there, nitya siddha. Similarly, Krishna bhakti, love of Krishna, that is also natural. It is not artificial. Nitya Siddha Krishna Bhakti. But somewhere or other, by our association with this material nature, we have forgotten. We are not material nature. That is the first education of Krishna consciousness or spiritual knowledge. We are spiritual, and Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is also a complete spirit. He is not material. Even the impersonalist, Shankaracharya, he has described about Narayana in his commentary on Bhagavad Gita, Narayana para of Bhaktyat. Narayana, the personality of Godhead, is not anything of this material world. Para abhaktyat andasambhava. But from the abhakta, this material world of the universe is created. Therefore, Narayana or Krishna, Krishna is the original Narayana. There is a big definition or understanding from Vedic knowledge. The Krishna from Krishna, first expansion is Baladev. From Baladev there is Sankarsan, Pradyumna, Anuruddha. In this way expansion takes place. And from Sankarsan also Narayana, Vaikuntha Narayana. And from Narayana, the Purushavatar, Vishnu, in this way, there is expansion. Ramadi Muttisu Kalaniya Mena Tishthana. So, the Narayana, or expansion of Narayana, Krishna, or expansion of Krishna, they are not of this material world. Narayana. Parastasmatu bhava anya. There is another spiritual word. Bhaktya bhaktya sanatam. A bhakta is material. And above this bhakta, there is a sanatam, eternal above. So, this Krishna consciousness movement, it is nothing of this material world. This Hare Krishna mantra, it is also not any vibration of this material world. There is a verse by Narottam Das Thakur, Golokera Premadhana Hari Nama Sankirtan. This Hari Nama Sankirtan is vibration from the spiritual world. Just like you receive some message, vibration of the material world from Europe, from America. So that is not Indian vibration, but American vibration or European vibration. Similarly, there is vibration in the spiritual world. Simply one has to catch. You must have that machine. So, that machine is there within you. The heart is the machine where you can receive the spiritual message. Because within the heart there is Narayana. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhese, particularly it is mentioned, riddhese. So because Narayana or Ishara is situated within the heart of everyone, there is no necessity of researching where is Narayana. The Shastra says it is within your heart. Therefore, the yogis, they practice yoga process, how to see Narayana within the heart. Dhyanavastita tadgatena manasa jang pashyanti yogi. The yogic process is to see Narayana within the heart. Similarly, you can hear also Narayana by this transcendental vibration. He can be perceived because we have got senses, different senses. We can see and we can hear also. Because the Supreme Personality of Godhead is absolute truth. By any of your senses, either by seeing or by hearing, it is the same. Nama Chintamani Krishna, Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha. Rasa Vigraha. Nama, this name, holy name of Krishna, or holy name of Rama. They are Rasa Vigraha, transcendental, blissful form. That is also Vigraha means form. That form is understood through the ear and it goes to the heart. In this way, we can perceive Narayana by chanting Hare Krishna Mahal. It requires little practice as they are enunciated in the Shastras and directed by the spiritual master. Then one can understand or one can see. Just like premanjana churita bhakti vilochane santa sadaiva hridayesu vilokan. The same thing hridaye. As it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Ishara sarvabhutana hridayesu arjuna tishtati. Similarly, the same thing is stated there in the Vedic literature. Bhagavad Gita is also Vedic literature, Brahma Sangita. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridayesu vilokan. Say the same thing, hridaya. So, anyone can see God within his heart. If he adopts the process, bona fide process, Narayana is within you. Therefore, great deep saintly person, we are sitting in a lonely place, alone. But he is not alone. He is with Narayana, Krishna. He is seeing always there. So he is not alone. We are always accompanied by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as Paramatma, Antarjami, within the heart. That is the Vedic statement, that there are two birds sitting on the same tree. One bird is enjoying the fruit of the tree, and the other bird is simply witnessing. So the two birds, Jivatma and Paramatma, are always associated. He is so kind. He is just looking forward when this Jivatma, who is illusion, bewildered, captivated by this material world, material enjoyment, when he will come back again to me. Just like father and the son who has gone out of home, the father is always looking forward when the son would come back at home and enjoy. Similarly, Krishna, the Supreme Father, is always looking forward when we shall go back to him. Therefore, he comes personally. Yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bhara tadatmanam sridhamaham. The general opportunity for human being is to understand God or Krishna and go back to him again. We have come from him, but we are attracted by this material enjoyment, which is not very pleasant. It is suffering. It's like here, without this fan, it was uncomfortable, excessive heat. So, excessive heat, excessive cold, so many things, adhibhautik, adhyatik, adhidaivik. We are actually suffering, always. This is the nature of this material world. Stringent laws of the material. And still, we are trying to become happy by some adjust. This is called struggle for existence. In this way, we cannot be happy. Real happiness is there. Jadgatyana nivartante tadhyama paramam mama vitorāga bhayos sopa manmaya madha mamupāsita bhavo gyāna tapasā sūta madhavam āgatā. These are the descriptions in the Bhagavad Gita. Vitarāga bhaya krodha. Vitarāga. Rāga means attachment. So we are now attached to this material world. So by practice, one becomes vitarāga. No more attachment for the material world. That is possible. Bhakti parishānu bhava virakti annatrasya. If you develop your normal bhakti or devotional life, that Krishna bhakti nitya siddha, saddha bhava, it has to be awake. Then you become vitarāga, bhaya krodha. And this material world is always fearful. Every living entity is fearful what will happen next. Just like at the present moment. Every time, always, we are here. Bhayam dhitya abhinivishatasyat. As soon as we forget our constitutional position and Krishna, then an artificial way of fearfulness is created. So vitarāga bhaya krodha. Manmaya ma mamupāsita, but this bhaya can be overcome. and this attachment can be overcome when we become Krishna conscious. Manmaya mamupasita bahava jnana tapasa puta madbhavam agata. Madbhavam, my nature, the spiritual nature of the spiritual world, they came. How? This is the process. Vitaraga bhaya krodha manmaya mamupasita bahava. Not only one, two, but bahava, many. Bahava jnanatapasa puta. By one has to be purified. That is called puta. Without being purified, you cannot enter into the spiritual world. Vitaraga bhaya. Jnanatapasa puta. Madhavam ava. So these are the statements of the Bhagavad Gita. And there are many other statements. So this Krishna consciousness movement is meant for taking back all the suffering humanity, all living entities, back to home, back to God. This is the sum and substance of Krishna consciousness movement. So here Krishna says that I am explaining to you how that knowledge of going back to home, back to Godhead can be attained. Therefore he is saying here, jnanam te aham abhijnanam. Jnanam means theoretical knowledge. That is called jnanam. And abhijnanam means practical knowledge. Just like in the scientific department of colleges. There are, for understanding anything scientifically, there are two divisions, practical and theoretical. So jnanam is theoretical. And vijnanam means practice. Simply to know there is God, this is theoretical knowledge. But when actually you become connected with God, you practice the godly activities, that is called vijnanam. So Krishna will explain in this chapter the knowledge of God, both theoretically and practically. Jnanam tiham sabijnanam bhakshami, I shall speak to you. Aseshata. Aseshata means vividly. Aseshata. Briefly, samanata. And when it is said aseshata, that means elaborate. But jadgatya, if somehow or other you understand this knowledge, jadgatya, na iha, in this material world, iha, iha means this material world. Bhuya, again, annas, anything more, jnatabham avasishyate, no more, you require no more further knowledge to understand. That is the statement in the Vedas. Jasmin vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavanti. If you simply understand Krishna, because Krishna is everything, so if you understand Krishna, automatically you understand what is this world, what is this earth, what is this water, what is this fire, this is material things. What is this air, what is this sky, what is this mind, what is this intelligence, what is this ego, and what is this soul. In this way, you understand everything. Because these material elements, earth, water, fire, air, sky, that will be explained in the next part. It is the expansion of Krishna's energy. As there are energies and the energetic. Just like the fire has got two energies. One energy is the heat and one energy is light. Just like in the morning, as soon as you see the light, from your window, you can understand that there is sunrise. By the energy, light of the sun, you can understand there is now the sun on the sky. Heat also. When you are too much heated, even within the room, even if you do not see the sun, you can understand that this heat is due to the sun. Similarly, we have to understand the presence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead by perceiving the different energies. Parasa Shakti Vividaivasya. At the present moment, we are trying to understand the energy of Krishna. We cannot see directly Krishna, but as soon as you see the energy, or you perceive the energy, you can understand there is Krishna, there is God. That is called intelligence. You cannot understand with your foolish brain what is God. That is not possible. They are trying to understand God by the limited senses. How you can understand? We are defective in so many ways. First of all, we commit mistakes. And we are illusioned. We try to cheat others. And our senses are imperfect. So, how you can understand with your limited senses, with so many defects? That is not possible. Therefore, you have to understand God from God Himself or from His dependencies. Therefore, Krishna said that Maya Saptamana Prata Yogami Jinjana Mad Asra. Mad Asra. Directly under my direction or under the direction of my representative. You cannot understand Krishna if you remain under your personal interest. That everyone says that I shall understand this by my own dint of knowledge, by speculation. That is not possible. Krishna says that you have to understand. Here also it is the same thing said, that jnanam teham sabhijnanam bhaksami aham. I shall speak. So this is the secret of success. If you want to understand God, what is God? Everyone, there are many philosophers, scientists, they are trying to understand God by research. But that research will not help you. You have to understand directly from God or from God's representative. That is the way. In the Vedic literature it is said, अथापि ते देव पदाम्बुजद्वयम् प्रसाद लेशानु गृहीत इव हि जानाति तत्त्वम् जानाति तत्त्वम् ते देव माय लॉर्ड वन हु हैज रिसीव वन हु इज एबल टू रिसीव ए लिटिल फेवर फ्रॉम यू ही कैन अंडरस्टैंड योर तत्त्व अथापि ते देव पदाम्बुजद्वयम् प्रसाद लेशानु गृहीत इव हि जानाति तत्त्वम् Nachanna ekopi chiram vichinna. Others who are simply speculating, they cannot understand. Therefore, people are bewildered how God is person. But they cannot understand because they have not taken shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, or His representative. It is impossible for him. Naham prakasa sarvasya yogamaya swan. Krishna cannot be exposed to the non-devotees. Naham prakasa sarvasya. Not anyone, ordinary common man, can understand. Therefore, we have to understand Krishna or the Supreme Personality of Godhead from Krishna, not from anyone who is simply speculating or wrongly interpreting Bhagavad Gita. They cannot understand. That is the way. Jnanam tiyam sabhijnanam vakshami asisaka jajgatyang neha bhuya bhandas jyata bhamma vasish. Therefore our Krishna consciousness movement is just to try to understand what is Krishna. That's all. What is Krishna? Because if you perfectly understand Krishna, then immediately you become liberated and you become eligible to be transferred to the spiritual world. That is taken. Dibbam. Janma karma me dibbam. Jo janati tattam. If one can understand Krishna, why he appears, why he disappears, they are not transcendental, they are not ordinary. Because we understand Krishna as a historical person. A person like me, maybe a very great personality with more power than me. Yes, that he is. But you do not know how much powerful he is, because he is God. He is powerful in full. There is no deficiency in his power. Vaisarjasya samantrasya bijasya jasasya. He is powerful in complete, purnam. Purnasya purnamadaya purnamai bhavishishya. Even though Krishna, from Krishna, all his power is taken away, he still is purnam. He still all powerful. Janma karma me dibbam ju janati tattata. So we have to understand Krishna in truth, not superficial. In scientific, vijnanam. Jnanam tiham vijyas, avijnanam. Not foolishly, that I can interpret Krishna. Some rascal says Krishna means black. Some rascal says Krishna means this. Krishna means divorce. As according to one's character and angle of vision. But the real meaning of Krishna is Parabrahma. Krishi Goba, Krishi Bhubhachaka Sabda, Nashta Nidviti Vasa, Tayo Raikyam, Iti Krishna Parabrahma Iti Avidhiyati. Krishna means Parabrahma. Krishna means all action. So we have to take the understanding of great personality, Rama. Rama, Rama means Parabrahma. Ramante Jogina Anante Satyanande Chidatman Iti Rama Padinasu Parabrahma Iti Avidhi. So this Hare Krishna, Hare Ram means direct connection with the Parabrahma. Rama Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasavidya Purna Suddha Nitya Mukta Abhinatya Namana. These things have to be understood. That nama nami avinatyat identity. So when we chant Krishna, Hare, Rama, they are directly connected with the Supreme Personality of God. Even though we do not know how to chant, there are, according to Shastri, injunction, there are 10 kinds of offenses. When we avoid that offense, then it is pure chanting of the Hare Krishna mantra. So even if we chant with offenses in the beginning, it cannot be free of offenses. Still, it will act. Just as you come near the fire, you can feel the warmth. And when direct touch, it becomes red hot. So we have to be in touch with the fire. Then gradually we become warmer, 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 warmer. And red hot. Red hot. Let's try another example. Just you take a red iron rod and keep in touch with the fire. It becomes warm, warmer, warmer. Then gradually the iron rod becomes red hot. When it is red hot, then it is fire. You touch that iron rod anywhere, it is burn. The quality of fire is already acquired. Similarly, if you keep always in touch with Krishna, smartakvam satato vismartambam na jatuchi, Ah. Sarve vidhi nishida suri toya revakanta. We, to become advanced in Krishna consciousness, the first principle is smartabho satato Vishnu. Always remember Vishnu or Krishna. That is the beginning, to touch. Vismartabho nagavas. Never forget. So this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, if you chant, there is no expenditure. But the profit is very, very great, because you are touched in Krishna. And Krishna and Krishna's name, non-different, identical. Nama Chintamani Krishna, Chaitanya Rasavigra, Purna. It is not that, partial, Purna. Because the name is of the Purna. Purna sa Purna Mahalaya, Purna Vaiva Vishishati. This is the Vedic verse. So, it is not very difficult. Simply try to be in touch with the vibration. Where is the wrong there? What is the loss there? If you chant just like this boy, you have seen the picture. They are taking it seriously. They are working in the field, Hare Krishna. They are working in the factory of incense factory, Hare Krishna. What is the wrong there? Why India is not taking this? If you work in your factory, if you chant Hare Krishna, what is the loss there? But you remain always in touch with Krishna. Smartabhu satato Vishnu, this formula is false. We shall talk so many nonsense things, but you are not desiring to chant Hare Krishna. This is our fault. Otherwise, Krishna is so kind. Nama rupe Krishna avata. Krishna is now descended in his vibration form, Hare Krishna. This Kali Yuga. Kali Yuga, because we cannot do anything, therefore Krishna has become very easily available in the form of his holy name, Hare Krishna. Krishna is available. You can see Krishna, you can touch Krishna, you can talk with Krishna. As you may advance in Krishna consciousness, that is possible. Then, gradually making progress means gradually you will be lover of Krishna. That is required. Mayasakta. As soon as you become lover, you become attached. That is required. Now at the present moment we are attached to so many things. Because we have forgotten Krishna. Now gradually, if you increase your attachment for Krishna, then you forget all this material. That is liberation. That is liberation. Bondage means we are becoming more and more attracted to this material world. And on account of this attraction, we have to accept another body, material body. And as soon as you accept the material body, you become under the control of this material nature. Liberation means to be free from the control of the material nature. It is a great science. Try to understand. Therefore it is said, jnanam triham sabhijnanam. It is not sentiment. It is not religious sentiment. It is a science. Krishna consciousness means to understand the science of Krishna. We are understanding so many subject matter scientifically, but we are neglecting one thing, how to understand Krishna scientifically. That science is described here. Jnanam triham sabhijnanam. Jnanam triham sabhijnanam. Aham bhakshami asisatam. Just get. If you simply try to understand the science of Krishna, then all other sciences will be automatically understood. It's like if you understand what is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, then you understand the whole mathematical science. Because the mathematics means that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this way, that way, this way, that way. The figures are all the digits are the 1, 2, 3, 4. So therefore one has to learn 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 9 and 0. Similarly, if you understand Krishna, the indirectly and directly, everything is Krishna. That is the highest scientific understanding of everything. That is a fact. But Krishna is earth. Krishna is water. Krishna is air. Krishna is fire. Krishna is sky. Krishna is mind. Krishna is intelligence. Krishna is ego. And Krishna is soul. So, this is required. Jnanam tehan sabhi jnanam. Then next verse, Krishna says that manusaram sahasi. Tasci jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhyanam tasci maang ditti tato. The same thing, tato. We have to understand. Fourth chapter, it is said that janma karma me divam yu janati tato. The tattvata, you can understand Krishna tattvata. Another place Krishna says, bhaktyamam abhijanati javan jasyami tattvata. So our aim should be to understand Krishna tattvata in truth, not superficially, not by foolish commentary. If we simply try to follow what Krishna said, what is the difficulty? There is no difficulty. But foolishly we interpret in a different way. And Maya takes away our knowledge. Maya aparita jnana. He is thinking that he is very learned scholar, but he is fool number, rascal number one. Therefore Krishna says, Maya aparita jnana. Navana duskitana mura parpadante narala. Krishna is speaking so many ways about himself. Without understanding Krishna in his own way, we are trying to understand Krishna in different way. Therefore, Krishna says, Maya aparita jnana. Asuri bhava. The atheistic class of man, they interpret in a different way because their knowledge has been taken by Maya. And why it is so? Because they are sinful. Duskritina, mura, narana. These things are there. You will find in Bhagavad Gita, it is not our manufactured word. Therefore, our proposal is, try to understand Krishna. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. Do not misinterpret, do not be misled by the misinterpreters. Then your life will be successful. You will understand what is Krishna, and you become Krishna conscious. Then, taktadvi hang punar jangmano iti mami iti kam. In the Western world, they are taking more and more seriously about this Krishna consciousness movement. So our only request is that in India also, at least those who are sympathetic with this movement, kindly try to understand Krishna scientifically, and your life will be successful. Thank you very much. Yeah.